Welcome back to my channel. It's a natural and very caveman egoistic nature of men with chest hair to believe that bigger is better, choosing an unnecessarily massive V8 American muscle car over a well-built German car. But there is always the compromise on the way the car handles, the way the car turns, dynamics and practicality. Yes, you will win in every drag race, but that's about it. The same applies with bikes. The tendency to choose a 1200cc bike over a practical 900 or even a 650 is always there. But then you seem to lose on agility and you tend to carry far more weight and power that you seldomly use. Well, now this is where the new Tiger 1200 comes in. She has completely transformed. Actually, transformed is an understatement. She has rewritten the rules of what every 1200cc bike is supposed to be. Suddenly, you have a much lighter bike that behaves closer to a 900 than the liter class siblings. Tiger has various variants, right from the GT, which is a more road-biased motorcycle, to the Rally Pro, which is a more off-road prepped version of the bike. There will be 5 versions of the new flagship Tiger in total. The base GT, the GT Pro, the Rally Pro. Now the GT Pro and the Rally Pro would get an option of an upgrade to the Explorer version, which will have a massive 30 liter of fuel tank. Now why 30 liters of fuel tank? Well, considering you're riding in the middle of Africa or even a remote location in your respective country, either the possibility of fuel pump is very low, or even if there is a fuel pump, you may not be confident on the adulterated level of fuel there. You don't want to take chances when your bike costs you upwards of 15,000 pounds. Hence, either way, 30 liters makes sense. Triumph has designed the 30 liter tank in such a way that the extra 10 liters of space is just integrated in the design. You won't even notice the difference. Triumph has not just worked their magic on the weight, but the way the weight is placed, the dynamics of the bike, the entire chassis has been redesigned. These bikes need a specific weight distribution. Too much weight in the front and the steering will feel too heavy. Too much weight in the rear and the steering will feel too light and unnatural. These are adventure bikes built for roads as well as off-road junkies. Hence, when you have the Rally Pro and jump around bumps like a 400cc dirt bike, the weight has to be centralized in such a way that both your tires land simultaneously. And I feel Triumph has hit the mark in that aspect as well. Now, the new bike weighs 240kgs. That means it's slightly less than 25kgs over its predecessor and weighs around 17kgs lighter than its nearest shaft-driven competitor, the BMW 1250GS. Now, heat is another major factor that we need to consider. You got to understand you're practically sitting on engines that can power cars and Jeeps. Triumph has cleverly redesigned the radiator, or may I say radiators, in such a way that there's one on each side of the tank. They have also considered the direction of flow of hot air, in which it will be designed to flow away from your thighs. I'm not saying you will not feel the heat, you will definitely, but much lower than say the previous model. Triumph has also completely designed a new chassis, and the rear chassis is bolted on. That means during a crash, you need not replace the entire frame, you just replace the part of the frame that has been damaged. Now coming to the endless features. Even the base Tiger GT comes packed with good amount of features, including the new keyless system which functions the ignition, steering lock and fuel lid, mounted knuckle guards, a brand new 7-inch TFT display with integrated connectivity system, 3 riding modes and a new LED lighting with DRLs. The top end model gets 6 riding modes: road, rain, off-road sport, off-road pro and rider. Each riding mode has its own pre-selected settings of ABS, TC, throttle maps and suspension settings. All the variants get new semi-active Showa suspension with automatic electronic pre-load and damping system. Brembo Stylema monoblock brakes along with cornering ABS. All models of new generation Tiger get the same suspension unit that allows the Tiger to have a 200mm of travel. The GT and Rally Pro get advanced suspension unit that allows the Tiger to have a 220mm of suspension travel. The highest spec Explorer models get integrated adaptive cornering lights, heated grips, cruise control, hold hill control, a bi-directional quick shifter, all as standard. Things that set the Explorer model apart from the rest are features like TPMS, that is tire pressure monitoring system, heated rider and pillion seats. Both models also features Triumph's new blind spot radar tech. The radar basically provides blind spot assistance and lane change assistance to rider. The GT comes with a 19-inch front and 18-inch rear cast aluminium wheels dressed in Metzeler Touring treads for dynamic road riding, while the Rally Pro gets a bigger 21-inch front and 18-inch rear tubeless spoke setup that comes with Metzeler Karo shoes, which is more apt for dual-purpose usage. Now, the most important aspect is cost of ownership. The place where Triumph not only exceeds expectations with reference to basic cost of ownership, comparatively low cost of spares and basic availability of spares, but also in the duration of your service cycle. There's a massive 16,000 km gap between service intervals. This talks a lot with reference to how well built the engine is, but also with reference to people who want to explore continents. This is a massive plus point. And with reference to normal chaps like you and me, this means we have got to spend far less in the service center than as opposed to the competitors. This is my view regarding the new Triumph Tiger 1200. As of now, if I may dare say, this is the best 1200cc bike that you could get in the market. I would look forward for your views regarding the same. Thank you for viewing my channel. If you haven't subscribed, please do. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video.